It's water, it's not vodka. Got to stay hydrated, folks. So this morning, I was on my way to work, you know, just sort of daydreaming, got my own thoughts. And I suddenly thought, why don't we eat chicken for breakfast? Like, bear with me, all right? Just think about it for a minute. You know, you think of your sausage, your bacon and egg, your toast, your cereal, croissants even. But someone says to you, oh, do you want a nice juicy chicken breast? Oh no, suddenly your brain has a meltdown. Why? It's nice. Weird, isn't it? I don't know. Just something I thought about. But on the theme of chicken, today's recipe is going to be a chicken Kiev. Now, I'm sure many of you are familiar with the chicken Kiev. It's normally bought from the shops in a little square plastic tub. You get two. And they're kind of that reformed chicken, you know, with sort of garlic butter in the middle. And invariably, they explode in the oven. So you end up with dry chicken, crappy breadcrumbs, and your garlic butter is all spilling out over your oven tray. Disaster. And they're nowhere near as tasty as the real thing. Now, what I will say is that if you're a novice cook, these are not going to be the simplest things to make. But give it some practice and you'll make perfect chicken Kievs every single time. Probably. Maybe not. 90% of the time? I don't know. But anyway, let's crack on with it. If you look down below in the description, you can get a list of the ingredients. And the first thing we need to do is make the garlic butter. Okay, so what we're gonna do is make a flavored butter, which is really, really simple. We've just got unsalted butter, we've got garlic, and we've got parsley. Gonna add a bit of salt and pepper as well. Now I'm gonna make more than what I need because this stuff is really, really good for all sorts of things. You can put it on steak, you can make garlic bread with it, put it on fish, you can add it to some pasta. You know, it's really, really versatile and it keeps well in the freezer as well, so always make more than you need. So I'm just gonna take half of this block of butter, which is 125 grams-ish, and just cut it into rough cubes. Don't need to be too precise. It also helps if the butter is at room temperature, which this isn't. So it's gonna be a lot harder for me to do it. But you know, it's still gonna be good. Next, we're gonna add some garlic. I'm gonna just take the skins off of these. Now that I've peeled the garlic, what we need to do is mince it. Now you can put it through a garlic press, but I'm gonna show you a really simple way to do it. So what I'm gonna do is just roughly chop it into nice fine pieces, just until you've got it as fine as you can. And then take a pinch of salt and just sprinkle it on the garlic like that. And then just gather it up, and then taking your knife, just use the back of it and sort of squash it down. And what's happening is that salt is acting like an abrasive and it helps break down that garlic. And the reason I do it this way is because if you use a garlic press, there's a lot of wastage, you know? You put it through the press and it all kind of sticks to the side, gets stuck in the little holes and whatnot, and you just kind of end up with about half a garlic clove. So by doing it this way, you get all of it. Okay, so just press it like so. It only takes a few seconds. And as you can see, you end up with nice, finely minced garlic. Okay, just like that. Put that in with our butter. And next we need to add some parsley. Now, if you're gonna ask me how much parsley you need, I'm gonna say about that much. It doesn't really matter, you know, you just want a nice good handful. And I'm just gonna squish that up into a tight little ball and then just run my knife through it. And then you wanna keep chopping, you know, because you want this quite fine. Right, so now we've added the parsley, I'm just gonna go in with some pepper, of the world's worst pepper mill. Honestly, this is just absolute trash. Seven quid this was, and it's absolute garbage. Look at that, not anything coming out of that. So I'll be here for about 5 minutes.
A few moments later.
Next, a pinch of salt. Now, just be careful if you're using salted butter that you don't add too much salt, because with it being salted butter, it's already got salt in it. This is why I like to use unsalted, because you've got much more control over how much is in it. Okay, so then what we need to do is take a fork and basically mash the hell out of it. Okay, so once your butter is mixed, all I'm gonna do is take a piece of baking paper, and I'm just gonna take the butter, plop it in the middle, okay, and just roll it up, just like so, and then just take the ends and sort of twist it in opposite directions. And what that'll do is it'll kind of force it into a sausage shape, like that, okay? Give it a bit of a roll, and that can go in the freezer as is if you wanna use it at a later date, but that'll happily sit in the fridge, it'll firm up whilst we get on and prepare our chicken. Right, so I've got my chicken here and I'm going to show you what I think is the best way to get that butter inside the chicken breast. Now there's lots of different ways you can do it, but in my opinion, I just think this is the best way. Now you can just use ordinary chicken breast, that's fine, but for this I'm using chicken supremes, and all that is because it's got the wings still attached. And I'm using these for two reasons. Firstly, because the bone helps keep it juicy and adds lots of flavour, and secondly, when you sort of add in the breadcrumbs and everything, that acts as a handle. Now this is the hardest part of making a Kyiv. Once you nail this, everything else is plain sailing. Now before we do anything, what I'm going to do is take off this. This is called the mini fillet. It's kind of like that small chicken breast fillet that sits underneath the breast, and I'm just going to whip that off and you'll see why later. Next, I'm going to flip it back over, and what we need to do is to make a pocket inside the breast. Now some people sort of go in the side and cut along, but what we're going to do is just go right in at the end here and create a small little pocket. So if I kind of move this around so you can see a bit better, taking a really sharp knife, hand on it nice and flat, and just kind of go in and create a small slit, okay, just like so, and then keeping your knife nice and straight, just very very carefully work your way through the chicken. Be very careful to make sure that the knife doesn't go through the chicken, because once you do that, it's game over. All your garlic butter is going to leak out. So be very, very careful and take your time. Just gently work it, keep your hand on there because you'll be able to feel where the knife is, and then stick your finger in. Gosh, it's really suggestive, isn't it? And you'll be able to feel, you know, how much room you've got for that garlic butter. If you want a bit more, be a bit more daring and just kind of cut into it. So that one's done. I'm going to crack on with the other one and then we'll move on to the next step. Right, so I've prepared my chicken breasts. Now, I've made a bit of a boo-boo with this one, okay? I did exactly what you shouldn't do, and I've gone too far with the knife, and it's pierced a hole in it. Now, what I have done is I've taken a bit of the mini fillet and stuffed it in there, hopefully to patch it up. But, you know, this is real life. This is real cooking. We make mistakes, okay? So for this video, I'm gonna use that one, okay? Because I think that one's okay. But I'll put this one in the freezer and I'll have it another day. And if it explodes, it explodes. It's not the end of the world. It's still gonna taste good. Okay, so now that they're done, we're ready to fill them up with the garlic butter. Right, okay, so let's fill these puppies up with this garlic butter. It's been sitting in the freezer for a bit just to firm up. Just makes life a lot easier to handle it. So what I'm gonna do is just unravel it a bit. And I'm just gonna take off a few little nuggets or slices. Okay, just with a clean knife, because you don't want chicken juice all over this when you want to use the rest of it for something else. So I take off about four nice pieces. Now I will put some garlic in this one that I ruined, but what we want to do is just take the garlic butter and stuff it in that hole that you created. And just sort of leave a bit of a gap just in the end, because I'll show you why in a minute. Once that's filled, just pop that to one side. Now, with the one that I'm going to use for my tea, do the same thing. Okay, so now that we've filled them, just move that bit of garlic butter out of the way. Remember, we kept these mini fillets, okay? So what we're going to do is trim these up. Probably need about half of that. And what we're going to do is just use a bit of that to stuff. I'm going to cut that a bit more, actually. Don't need all of that. Just kind of stuff it in the end. And that creates like a little plug, so it helps stop your garlic butter leaking out. Now these are ready to be breadcrumbed. Now I'm not going to use this one now, I'm going to have this another day. So I'm going to pop that to one side. And I'm just going to pop this one on a plate for now. I'll pop it back in the fridge whilst we get on, make the egg wash, get the flour, get the breadcrumbs ready and all that business. So I've got my Kyiv out of the fridge. It's now time to pan it. It's just a fancy term for adding breadcrumbs. So just pop that there for 1 second. So I've got my plain flour here. We're just going to add some seasoning to that. Just a pinch of salt and also some pepper from this world's most useless pepper mill. Just kind of mix that in. Okay, so we're going to take our Kyiv. It's nice and chilled. Just go over it again. Just double check there's no holes in it. I think we're good. Feeling pretty confident, but could all go wrong. We're going to go in the flour. Just take your time with it. Be nice and careful with it. Dab off the excess into the egg. Make sure it's coated. And then what we're going to do is go back into the flour again. This is like the glue. It's going to help this Kiev really stick together. Again, off with the excess, into the egg, and then into our breadcrumbs. Okay, I'm using panko because these give a really nice crunchy texture. Really kind of pack them on nice and tight. And that is the Kiev breadcrumbed. So I'm gonna pop that back onto the plate. I'm gonna stick it back in the fridge for a bit, just have a bit of a clean down, and then we're ready to cook. How am I gonna turn the camera off with these hands? Oh God, with my face? Right, so I've got my pan here and we are ready to rock and roll. Got my spuds on, got some beans. And what I'm gonna do is just put a layer of oil in this pan. I'm not deep frying it because I'm gonna finish it off in the oven, but just enough to shallow fry it. Okay, and then I'm gonna get this onto a medium-ish heat and let that oil heat up. Right, so the oil is hot enough now so we can get the chicken in. Just be very careful. Just gently place it in the oil. Now what we're looking to do here is just color it, okay? We're not looking to cook it all the way through. I just want to get it nice and brown on each side because then we're going to finish it off in the oven. So I'm going to brown this off for a couple of minutes each side. Meanwhile, I've preheated the oven to gas mark 5 to get it nice and hot before we put it in the oven. Right, so after about a minute, we just want to turn that over very, very gently, okay? You don't want to undo that hard work that we put in at the beginning. And once you've browned it on both sides, that's now ready for the oven. Now that's going to take around about 15 to 20 minutes to cook. Now it depends on the size of the chicken breast and your oven as well, but 15, 20 minutes, maybe 25, you're going to be golden. And whilst it's getting on with itself, you can get your veg on, get your potatoes, chips, rice, soup, whatever it is you're having with it, and then we can plate it up and get stuck in. Right, okay, so got my veg, got my spuds plated up, but what we're really interested in is this Kiev. So I'm just gonna get this on the plate. Don't see any signs of leakage in the pan, so could be good. There it is, the chicken Kiev. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, I suppose we should cut into it and see what's inside. I'm quite nervous, to be honest. I hope it's worked out. Right. God, let's just do it. Okay, well, okay, it's not bursting out of there, but you can quite clearly see that that's garlic butter. I don't know where the rest went. I mean, there's no real leakage in the pan. Perhaps it's absorbed itself into the chicken. But anyway, what I'm gonna do is take the thumbnail and then we'll give this puppy a try. Right, let's dig in. I'm gonna go straight for the Kiev because that's all we really care about. Yeah, the garlic butter is in there, but it must have leaked out somewhere because, you know, it should be oozing out, but we'll give it a taste. Who cares that I haven't got a pool of butter oozing all over the plate? That is freaking delicious. The chicken is still really, really juicy, and that butter has gone all the way through the chicken and just made it really, really flavorful. Well, there we are, that's my chicken Kiev. Not a complete success, but certainly not a failure by any stretch, because that is one delicious plate of food. So where did that butter go? It's not in the pan, it's not in the chicken. So what is it, some sort of dairy fairy going around stealing liquid butter from Kievs? I don't know. But anyway, the crux of it is, they're really, really delicious. Make them yourself because they're miles better than any shop-bought trash, and you probably do a better job than me, to be fair. But anyway, that's my chicken Kievs done. I'm gonna wrap up this video, let you guys get on with your business. And if you like this video, then please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see your gorgeous faces next time for more tasty fun and frolics. And bye for now.